Hey guys, it's Jenna here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So this is going to be the start of a new vlog. This is reading week challenge number 4, I believe. So I'm not like starting a reading challenge yet because it's still June. I'm going to start it 1st of July. But I did want to give you a haul before I forgot about it, because Rachel and I went to Barnes & Noble today. Picked up 3 books. So the first one I picked up was Daughter of the Siren Queen by Trisha Levenseller. I figure if I have the Daughter of the Pirate King on my TBR, I might as well pick this one up, because I have a feeling I'm probably really gonna like it if it lives up to the hype. And then I also picked up Last Night at the Telegraph Club by Melinda Lowe. And basically what I gather from this, that this is like a it's gay, and it's set in 1954 in Chinatown, and I think it sounds fantabulous. Plus, I love the cover. And then I finally just bit the bullet and picked up Ariadne by Jennifer Saint. I picked it up because it was 15% off, and I've been wanting this book forever, but never wanted to spend, like, the full amount on it. So I finally picked this up. So I went in for 2 other books. I went in for From Blood and Ash in hardcover, and then Dance of Thieves by Mary E. Pearson. They didn't have either one of them.
Hey guys, so it is just a couple minutes past 11:30 on Thursday. Is today Thursday? Yes. Thursday, July 1st, which means it is officially time to give you guys the first week's worth of my weekly TBR challenge. I am about to leave for work though, so I gotta can't linger and stuff like that, but let's get on into it. So the first book, the bones of this TBR, essentially, House of Earth and Blood, aka Crescent City by Sarah J. Maas. This book has been a particular thorn in my ass for over a year, and it just really needs to get read, like, really. It's kind of ridiculous at this point, honestly. So we're gonna take all the other tabs out of it so I don't get underwhelmed. Actually, I'm gonna keep the yellow tabs in, but I feel like I'm actually ready to read this book this time though. Like, if I can make it through A Court of Silver Flames in 5 days, reading about my least favorite character in the series, come on. Like, this is literally the same amount of pages, if not, like, the same. It's 800 pages. So I would really much so like to get to this, finally. And then we have, to break up the fantasy that I have in this TBR, we have An Emotion of Great Delight by Tahereh Mafi, and this is a nice and short contemporary to break up the fantasy, so here's that one. And then finally, we have Captive Prince by C.S. Picot. This is book 1 in a, believe, a 3-book series. It's a trilogy. Love how it just says mature audience at the bottom. But that is my TBR for this week. It's going to run from today, the 1st, to the 7th, which is a Thursday. So my vlogs are going to be kind of really random this week, because, or I should say this month, because none of the weeks are ending from like Monday to Sunday. They're going from whatever starts a week in the month, and you know, they're just going with the flow. So vlog schedule is going to be a little bit weird for me. I'm used to like doing a weekly reading vlog from Monday to Sunday, but it's going to be a little different, starting it in the middle of the week and it's going to end in the middle of another week. So should be interesting. I'm really, really hoping I can at least finish one of these books, because I just don't want my whole TBR challenge last month to be like a fluke. So I'm really just wanting to keep in this reading mood. But I do have a pretty crazy work schedule next week. I work like 5 8-hour shifts in a row, so not quite sure how that's gonna work. I'm also gonna be babysitting one of my mom's kittens so that she can get the mom fixed. and I am going with Rachel to a consultation appointment, hopefully, as long as I can get my shift covered on Wednesday. So I'm really crossing my fingers that I can get everything done, but I'm trying not to beat myself up too bad about it if I don't, because I'm set to finish my 4 weeks worth of TBR on the 28th, which gives me the 29th, 30th, and 31st to get like a catch-up day. And actually, I took off the 20th through the 23rd, so I should have some reading time in between those as well. But yeah, I figured I would give you guys an update, open up the vlog, let you know what I was planning on reading this week before I went to work. So this is what we're focusing on this week. I feel like I should bring one of these to work because I'm going to get a 45-minute lunch and 2 15s. But I almost never read on my breaks. I don't know, I probably won't read on my break. Unfortunately, it's just really hard for me to get into the reading zone while I'm at work and I'm thinking like, wow, I'm at work right now. So I'll figure something out though. I do have tomorrow off, which is nice. I do have a lot of things to get done, but maybe I can find one of these on audio. So yeah, I will check in with you guys later, but I wanted to give you guys the TBR rundown and update you guys before I went to work. Good morning, y'all. So it is just about 10, I want to say. I'm not 100% sure what time it is, but it is Saturday, July 3rd, so I am extremely behind on this first week's worth of vlogging. It just didn't end up working out like the way that I thought it would. I had so much to do, and then I don't know, I just got in this really weird funk, and long story short, I haven't started anything yet, so we have until the 7th, which I believe is a Wednesday. And it's currently Saturday, so we have Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. We have 4 days to complete these. If I'm being honest, it technically is possible, and it would be possible for most people. For me, though, I'm a little nervous, just because I know how things have been going and what my reading moods have been like. We're gonna read this and we're gonna see how far we get. I don't have to work until 5 and then I'm off tomorrow. So maybe, just maybe, if I can get through this, I know that I can finish this week's TBR. So normally I would start with the smaller books, say knock those out, and then at least I have 2 books finished and only 1 big one left. Nay, nay. This week we're saying go with the big one. We're gonna go in strong. So here we go, I guess. But I'm thinking. Did you bring me your fish? Come here. Bring me your fish. Bring it here. Nana, bring it here. I am going to start Crescent City. Get my heart ripped out in the first 100 pages all over again. And I think this time I'm actually going to get through it. It's really not that long if I really think about it, honestly.
Oh, this is nice.
Look at the grass, it's been bricks.
Oh my.
I'm tripping balls right now. Are you fucking
Dude, if you spit from right here, you could kill someone. Can you believe this? Queen mass. What up? It's your favorite inconsistent booktuber. So it is currently like 7 o'clock on Wednesday the 7th. Today the vlog is supposed to end. Let's do some updates, shall we? So I was supposed to finish Crescent City, An Emotion of Great Delight, and The Captive Prince. It was a little bit more of a crazy week than we were anticipating. So unfortunately, I only made it to chapter 16, page 180 in Crescent City, and I did not read the rest of the week. I've been slowly trying to chip away at that, but it's been really chaotic. I ended up having more plans than I thought. Today, Rachel and I didn't get back until like just now. But to make up for my lack of reading, I'm gonna give you guys a little haul of what I got from the mall. Visited a big Barnes and Nobles and it was 10 out of 10. Blew too much money there. Met the sweetest clerk in my entire life. And what we're gonna do going forward in the challenge is I am not going to stop next week's challenge to make room for to finish the three books I didn't finish this week. Instead, I'm going to wait at the end of the month when I have my days off. I am going to set a couple of those days aside for a readathon, and I'm going to try to cram them out then. But if I don't finish them this month, then they're just going to get bumped to next month's TBR. I'm not going to stress it too much. I didn't end up finishing them. What else is new? Not that big a deal. So let's get into the haul, shall we? Nana's very happy to see me. I've been gone since 10 a.m. So Rachel had an appointment in Troy, so we got to go to, we were going to go to Somerset, but they're more expensive and stuff like that. So we went to Forever 21 instead. I mean, Great Lakes Crossing. And it was very nice. Everything was so much cheaper there. So first, I actually got the shirt that I'm wearing because by the time we got out of Barnes & Noble, it was downpouring. So literally, Rachel and I took our shoes off, put them in our shopping bags, and bolted to the car at top speed in the rain. We looked ridiculous, and we were drenched head to toe, like head to toe. My hair is still wet. And that was over an hour ago. And we changed our shirts because my shirt was drenched. And I was getting so cold and uncomfortable. Oh yeah, here's my shirt. It's still soaking wet. Poor shirt. Anywho, so I got this shirt. 10 out of 10. Love it so much. And this Forever 21 actually had plus sizes. So I found this sweater on sale. It's just a crew neck, but it's so cute. And it's got a little embroidered deer on it. And this was literally only $7. It was regularly $20. So Rachel and I got matching ones of these. And she and I got this same shirt, and then, oh, what else did I get? It was really nice because Rachel has Afterpay, so she was able, we only had to pay $15 of our Forever 21 order between the two of us. And then, these are really big, more like, way bigger than I'm used to, but they were so cute. They're just gold hoops, but the little, they're all suns, and I thought that that was really cute. And I'll probably wear these to work, honestly. I'm just not a fan of how small the backing is. Like, you'd think that there would be a little bit more space, but whatever. No matter. Then I got this super cute silk, black silk tank top, and it is adorable. I love it so much. What else? Oh, I found a pair of biker shorts, finally. that might actually fit right. So these are from Forever 21. And these, that tank top was only, it was on sale for $7. And then this was, these were only $5.99. This shirt was only $5.99. I was like, man, come on, you really can't beat these prices. And then two more things. I just got a plain cami because all of mine are starting to get really worn out. And I decided to get a color I normally don't get. So I got this like periwinkle color and it's so cute. And I believe this was only $4.99, yeah. So they have super nice basics. And then I also found this sweater on clearance. And it's literally just a ribbed turtleneck. It looks super small, but I tried the sleeves, which are usually my biggest issue, and they fit. So that was mighty nice of them. And this was only $5 on clearance. So that's what I got from Forever 21. And then we did go to Victoria's Secret, but I'm only going to show you two of the things I got because reasons. And I had to get Love Spell. I couldn't find it in the non-shimmer, but that's fine. But Love Spell is just, did I say Blood Spell the first time? I've been reading too much fantasy. I just couldn't go to Victoria's Secret and not get Love Spell. I grew up smelling my sister's Victoria's Secret Love Spell perfume, and it's nostalgic. And then I got one called Beneath the Palms that smells really good. It's Desert Willow Aloe Water. Lush greens float on the breeze. And then I'm gonna save the book haul for last. I blew so much money today and I was literally beginning to think. So I told Rachel before I left, I'm like, are you gonna be mad if I don't get anything? And then today I was like, cause I can't really think of anything that I need or like really want. And then we get into town and I'm like, there goes that idea. So then we went to Marshall's and HomeGoods because I have my employee discount that works at both places. But this was a combined store. I found a green onyx tower at HomeGoods. So yeah, I found a green onyx tower and I'm so pumped about it. I love this. One of my main goals at HomeGoods was to find a crystal, and I did. Granted, there's a really good chance that it's not real because it was only $20. There's almost 100% chance that it's not real, but it says green onyx and that it was made in Pakistan. So I don't know. But even if it's not real, it's really pretty and I really love it. And I lugged it around for 20 minutes, so I deserved it. Plus, it only took $5 off my order. That's sad. And then, oh yeah, the associate at Barnes & Noble wrote me this. She said, if you guys like fantasy retellings and a little smut, to try the Wicked Villain series by Katie Robert. Because, so here's the thing, they had the most phenomenal book section I have ever seen at a bookstore before. Like, I thought my Barnes and Nobles was stocked. There were 10 aisles of just young adult. I was shocked. Mine only has 5. It was at least 10. I didn't even make it through all of them. I seen books I've never heard of in my entire life that look so good. I could have blown serious money in there. I mean, I still did, but you know what I mean. So anyways, at Marshall's, I found this top. Kind of ugly, I know, but it's like a little mock neck. And the reason I got it is because I thought it would be cute for fall, and it was only $3.50. So who knows? If I don't wear it, I'll just donate it. I'm not going to show you one of the items. And then I found these adorable sleep shorts. I just love how vibrant they are. And they got little cheetahs, or maybe they're leopards. They got like leopards and toucans on them, and they're so cute. And then the other pair is just gray, but they're so soft and so comfy. So glad that I bought them. And then the haul you guys are all waiting for. So here's the thing. I was going to pick up from Blood and Ash in hardcover because they had it, but it was $31.99. And I almost picked up A Touch of Darkness, but it was $28. Anywho. So, the first book I got is The Rich Kingdom by Danielle L. Jensen. This one's been going around a whole lot on BookTok and on my Sarah J. Maas group. Not even 100% sure what it's about, but I'm pretty sure that this is an enemies to lovers. So, something like that. And then I got, this is the one that the associate recommended to me. She recommended, highly recommended, Neon Gods by Katie Robert. And from what I understand, this is a Persephone, Hades and Persephone retelling. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's a Hades and Persephone retelling, and that's all. And then finally, I forgot that this book was out, but I found it, and it is Survive the Night by Riley Sagar. Super excited for this one, guys. I'm really excited. I did not even read the synopsis. I was just like, you know what? I've been waiting for this a long time. So, yeah, that was my massive haul today. God, it hurts to see how much I spent on some of these books. But, anywho, that is my haul. So sorry on the lack of reading, but I, like, don't even remember what happened this week. It was just a complete blur. I was working, and I still have to work the next couple days. I do have this weekend off, but I'm starting to get a lot of plans racked up, and it's like, ooh. So, anyways, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I'm sorry that the reading challenge didn't go as planned this week, but let's hope that we can do better next week. So, thank you again for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next week for a new reading vlog.